Namaste everyone. I am Neetu Somani, your host and moderator for today. I am a yoga instructor and yoga therapist from Singapore. It is a great pleasure and honor to be among such great dignitaries and speakers today. Aap sabhi ka main tahe dil se swagat karti hoon. As you all know, 21st June is the International Day of Yoga. And we have started the celebrations already. Youthnews.online in association with National Youth Foundation, Indian Yoga Association, and Paramarth Niketan Ashram have organized International Yoga e-conclave, and today is the second day. We have some renowned and eminent speakers from all over the world to enlighten us. Yesterday was the first day of the conclave, and we had the privilege to listen to many spiritual gurus and yoga masters from all over the world sharing their wisdom and knowledge with us. It is my pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to all of you for the second day of International Yoga e-Conclave 2021. I would like to thank the sponsors of the conclave who are City Montessori School, Vishwa and Vyasa Canada, the Art of Living Foundation, Hum Purna Yog Institute, Sarva Yoga International, Resonance the Yoga Studio, International Naturopathy Organization, SBPASS, World Yoga Federation, Yoga Alliance International, Sunmark Event Expert, Adhyatma Yoga Kendra, Soham Department of Yoga and Naturopathy, MJ College, Jalgaon, Anand Ashram Pondicherry, Dr. Nutan Ayurveda and Garbh Sanskar Academy, Manav Dharam Argentinian Hindu Parishad. Thank you all. The reach and spread of yoga today spans across continents. There are communities of yoga practitioners in almost every country in the world today. In order to benefit fully from yoga, to understand yoga in its entirety, we must reflect on who is a yogi. There is a beautiful shlok in Bhagavad Gita where Lord Krishna says, Yasmano dvijate loko, lokano dvijate chayah, harshamarsh bhayo dvegair, muktoya sach me priyah. By whom the world is not disturbed, and he who is not disturbed by the world, who is free from joy, impatience, fear, and distress. He is also dear to me. As you all know, we are going through extraordinary times with the pandemic still quite prevalent. As the world battles the COVID-19 pandemic on a war footing, India's traditional system of yoga has been established as a means to boost immunity, improve overall health and well-being. On 20th March 2020, Director General of the WHO also suggested that people could do yoga to maintain their physical and mental health. This will not help you only in the long term, it will also help you to fight COVID-19 if you get it, he suggested.
To welcome you all on behalf of youthnews.online, Paramarth Niketan Ashram and Indian Yoga Association, in the International Yoga e-Conclave 2021. आज हमारे बीच में बहुत सारे ऐसे व्यक्तित्व हैं, महान विभूतियां हैं, जिनसे वैसे रूबरू हो पाना शायद मुश्किल होता, लेकिन कोरोना ने काफी सब कुछ आसान कर दिया और शायद हम लोग इस प्लेटफॉर्म पर यहाँ पर ऐसे समय में हैं जबकि पूरा देश कोरोना से जूझ रहा है और ये सही जरूरत है, ये कार्यक्रम इस समय की जरूरत बन चुका है। ऐसे कार्यक्रम में यहाँ आए हुए सभी अतिथियों का, यहाँ पर आए हुए सभी महान विभूतियों का मैं हार्दिक स्वागत, वंदन एवं अभिनंदन करता हूँ। दिस इवेंट इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय youthnews.online इन एसोसिएशन विद इंडियन योगा एसोसिएशन, परमार्थ निकेतन आश्रम एंड इंडियन योगा एंड नेशनल यूथ फाउंडेशन। This event is supported by City Montessori School, Vishwa and Vyasa Canada, the Art of Living Foundation, Hanspurna Yoga Institute, Sarva Yoga International, Resonance the Yoga Institute, International Naturopathy Organization, SB Pass, World Yoga Federation, Yoga Alliance International, Sanmarg Event International, Adhyatma Yoga Kendra, Soham Department of Yoga and Naturopathy, MJ College, Jalgaon, Ananda Ashram, Pondicherry, Dr. Nutan Ayurveda at Garbh Sanskar Academy, Manav Dharma, Argentina, Hindu Parishad. We'd like to welcome everyone on board. We'd like to welcome Mr. Ravi Tripathi, Indian Idol finalist, and who represented India internationally in Asian Games. We would like to welcome chief guest, Dr. H.R. Nagendra Guruji. He has joined us. We welcome you all on behalf of our entire team and on the behalf of the supporting organizations. We would like to welcome Ms. Bhanumati Narasimhan, the chairperson, Women Empowerment and Child Care Programs from Art of Living Foundation. We would like to welcome Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, founder CMS Group of Institutions. We would like to welcome Dr. Ananda Balyogi Bhavnani Ji, Chairman ICYER and Yoganjali Natyalam. We would like to welcome Subodh Tiwari Ji, Vice President, Indian Yoga Association and Founder Director, Kavalya Dham. We would like to welcome Sarita P. Naik, the founder of UGLC and the faculty of AYG Academy. We would like to welcome Dr. Ishwar K. Baswareddy, Director Murarji Desai, National Institute of Yoga, Dr. Vishwas Manlikji, founder Yoga Vidya Dham, Swamini Durga Saraswati Ji, the faculty, Peter Rosina, founder Project P-Slides, Apainay Das, president ISKCON Temple, Dr. Satendra Kumar Mishra, faculty member, Faculty of Yoga and Alternative Medicine, Lucknow University. We would like to welcome you all on board for making this event a memorable event. And ek bar punah yahan aaye hue sabhi atithiyon ka main अपनी संस्था youthnews.online की तरफ से, परमात्म निकेतन आश्रम की तरफ से, नेशनल यूथ फाउंडेशन की तरफ से और इंडियन योगा एसोसिएशन की तरफ से हार्दिक स्वागत, वंदन एवं अभिनंदन करता हूं और इस कार्यक्रम को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए अपने होस्ट से अनुरोध करता हूं। धन्यवाद।
Now I have a pleasure to invite our next guest for today, Dr. Vishwas Mandlik Ji, who is the founder of Yoga Vidya Dham. Today he will enlighten us about how yoga can help us in the personality development. I welcome you, Dr. Vishwas Ji.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.
And welcome to you all yogacharyas, yoga gurus, yoga teachers, and everybody. I want to interpret one more point of yoga. Yoga is a multidimensional science. It has become very popular, but mostly yogasanas, pranayamas, they have become very popular. And they are connected with health. It is not wrong, but it is not complete. Yogic practices do help to improve the health, no doubt. But I want to say that it is a total personality development science. You know, yoga is to join. And as Dr. Basavareddy also has clearly explained, joining Atman with Paramatman. So Paramatman is the controller of the whole universe, or even multi-universe, whatever the bigger is there. And Atman is a part and parcel of the Paramatman, but controlling only a body, maybe for 100 years. So it's just like a drop of an ocean. Ocean is Paramatman, a drop is Atman. And now yoga provides ways and means to develop this Atman up to the level of Paramatman. Patanjali also says, Purusha Visheshaha Ishwara. Purusha is Atman, Purusha Visheshaha Ishwara is Paramatman. So the yoga is designed for this. And what is this process from Atman to Paramatman? It is a process of development. For example, we can say there is a worker in factory doing work in some section under a supervisor. So he thinks of getting promotion to be supervisor. He gets it, he becomes supervisor. Then he wants to be engineer, he becomes engineer. So on, finally becomes a president of the group of industries. So this is a development from one person to the president. Similarly, yoga is also a development from Atman to Parma. So it's a process of total development. And that is why I call it as a total personality development, to simplify on our level. Because Atman and Paramatman is working on spiritual level, very difficult to understand for a common person also. But we must interpret that it's a developmental process. And then we can apply it to all aspects of human life. Starting with physical development. What is physical development? Functioning properly physically. If every organ is functioning properly, we can say it is health, as per WHO's definition also. So that can be achieved. But still, development in that, improving the work efficiency physically. That works actually, we are experiencing. And many of you also might have experienced. If we continue to practice yoga, our physical efficiency increases. We can do the work, same work with less time, or we can do more work in the same time. So that is increasing the efficiency. That is a development. That is definitely possible with all these yogic practices. If you consider on mental level, that is more important. Mind is very powerful. Actually, the Atman is controlling the mind, mind is controlling brain, and brain is controlling the body. So with the practice of yoga, mental power can be increased. Mind has got tremendous powers, but most of them are hidden. But Patanjali also has given systematic way. Firstly, he gives Chitta Vritti Nirodha, how to control the functions of mind. And after he gives the development of mind, Prajna Lokaha, Dharana Dhyana Samadhi, and Dattajayat Prajna Lokaha. So that is a development or extrapolation of the powers of the mind, we can say, which is beyond the capacity of understanding for a human being. We cannot understand. So Patanjali calls it Siddhis. Prajnaloka is attaining Siddhis. In third chapter, he has explained all number of Siddhis. He has given the systematic explanation also, and many, many examples also. We can experience to some extent, but he has given very systematically. So how to develop the mental power? That is with the help of Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. So this mental development also is possible. Then there is an intellectual development, development of the brain. It is known that brain has got millions and billions of cells, every human being. But all of them are not functioning. Scientists say only 10% brain cells are functioning for an intelligent person in the world. The intelligence is less, it may be 4-5% also, but not more than 10%. And intelligence IQ is limited to 140. Science says there is nobody who is having the IQ above 140. So intelligence has got limit of functioning of brain. And this Patanjali's techniques and yoga, we can say, it gives rise to awakening of the remaining brain cells, 90%. Step by step, not suddenly. That is what is called awakening of Kundalini. Awakening the brain cells which are dormant. Yoga has got number of practices for that. So we can say intelligence development also is there. Even if you think of within limit, then we can observe with the regular practice of yoga, the intelligence means IQ can increase. You have carried out some experiments in the schools also, where you can measure the IQ and all these parameters of the intelligence. That is maybe understanding, concentration, decision-making, and all those. So psychological tests are available. First, we can test it, then we can continue with yogi practices. And after 3, 2, or 4 months, we can again recheck it. We can find everything is increased. So definitely intelligence can increase. That is also a development, intelligent development. And above that, we can say the spiritual development, which is beyond the reach of modern science. But it is there. And that is what is expected, rather. Development of Atman to level of Paramatman is all total spiritual development. So all these types of developments are definitely possible with yogic practices, and Patanjali has given Kriya Yoga for that. In particular, the Ashtanga Yoga, which all of you know, I need not explain in detail. But all these Ashtanga Yoga practices are there. There are so many other ways and means also, just for Om chanting and all. That is also explained by Patanjali. So every practice of yoga is definitely aiming to the target of total personality development and then spiritual development also. So we must understand this and make use of all these techniques. And that is why we can say yoga is useful for everybody. The development is a core of our life. Everybody wants development. We work very hard from the beginning to develop the physically, mentally, intellectually, to some extent spiritually. So it is definitely useful. And that is why yoga has to be appreciated in this way to get the proper development. And that will definitely help the individual also and to the society also. And this development only will give you the mental stability, mental control, which is very essential for today's social life also. So if you interpret these things and use these techniques, definitely we can make use of all this. A lot of things can be told, but most of you know very many main practices of yoga. And time limit also is there. Again, end to my topic. I thank you for the organizers. Thank you for all of you. Hari Om.